because there's no width anymore. Width is not a W is not a valid value. Actually, we just need to do this. Get up in the right frigging window. There. I knew I had to do something with that condition, and it did. I forgot to migrate the changes downward to the how it was being set. It didn't throw, again, no errors because of whatever reason. No W is undefined error, which is very strange. But... there we go. Okay. Yep, that looks good. Now I want to pull this out because I don't want this to turn red. And actually, to be honest, this should go out here. It shouldn't go below. That would have fixed that one problem. Well, part of that problem. That should always be drawn, but it should always be white. The red should be the cost. You know what? I take that back. We need to go backwards with this. We should have what it costs and then your current goal. But the cost should always be drawn. First and always in white. Flip around the item cost as well. Oh, we need to change the X and Y's. So here's another lesson. You can put something second in the coding. That doesn't mean it's going to be showing up second on the thing when it comes to window development. Alright. And, damn it, yet again. Here we are, trying to save it in the friggin' window over there. Let's get rid of that. Okay, there we go. Gold cost, current gold, because we don't have it. And now we do. Okay, much better. It's kind of small in the text, but nothing I can do about that without changing the size of these windows. Other windows. So it's about right in the middle, and then we could go a little bit higher to push it down a little bit more, but it wouldn't be enough to make a difference, really, I don't think. Well, I don't know, maybe that's not true. Maybe we can go up two more points. Okay, that's a bit better. We'll need to change the... So, the gold cost width. So just that plus this. Interesting. But apparently the width that we have for this now is exactly what it needs to be shown at the... Actually, this does seem to be a little bit crunched down, to be honest with you, looking at it. I think we just happen to have 20 more than we needed for the current gold text. I'll probably have to do an offset on that now. It's all just a matter of degrees. Dropped it by 5. I don't think that'll be that big of a difference. Not really. So if we just take it off entirely again. Probably better not to have an offset, to have the offset be up here instead of down there. To be honest with you. So we're not making these more complicated than they already are. It's pretty good. It's pretty close. We can add maybe a few more pixels to that. Maybe 78 or maybe 70. Let's try 70. Let's try 80 actually. Maybe, but might be better just to go to full X5. All right, so we got that now. Obviously, now we got the item cost thing issue here. So current potion cost. Item text already has it on it, that's why. And actually then we want to take this out. Basically do what we did before, just in reverse. Well, not reverse, exactly what we did before. This is why... plus 8 times 2. Actually, now in this case, we have to do both in here because it's going to depend on whether we have it or not. So if we don't have it, it's just nothing. If we do have it, it's... Yeah, because we have two things to add in there. Alright, F5. So next we'll take a look and see how that's all setting up, and then we'll try it with gold turned off and item turned on. Alright, current potion cost 0. So I have this up for 200 for the item text length. Well, here's the thing though, so... we need to do the same thing we did before, which was to do two of them, so... item cost W, which is this one. And var... current items width, which will be per item text so plus 200 so we'll say to ten service. And this one's just gonna be like 70 or something service. And then we'll need to obviously do the their current plus item text. No. Plus this. So actually, I probably won't need to be, because we don't have current there, so it would still be like 165, I think. This will be cur item text, ITM text. All right, then item text, cur item text. See how that looks. Okay, game. Crap. I just realized that this is also undefined down here. But it's not throwing an error for some reason. Why not? There's no W coming through. No W being set anywhere. That should seriously have been throwing an undefined error. What the hell? I think I've broken the universe just now. W is not defined still. Where is it being used at, though? Nowhere. I SSW. Oh, here. Very strange. I wonder if I had to find it there somewhere and I'd removed it just now or something. I don't know. Alright, so current potion, and then we got this huge friggin' space here. It's probably not even gonna be this much, it'll probably be like 110. Let's try that. Because it's a little bit more than what's on current gold cost, and that's about 85. Pretty close. Actually, in fact, that's very close. So now that we got that, we need the cost for potions. Well, the cost for items. So we're not going to do it the same way we did it with Novice. The first way we did it with the level cost. Cost based on level. It's got to be... How do we do this? So it's using the same formula, obviously. So we have to figure out some value to throw back to here that's not going to generate some crazy number like ten thousand. So this is for gold cost only, so we can do something similar for item cost. Oh wow, I didn't notice this on this now. Oh no, that's right. This should all be in an undefined check. So item cost. Now probably a better way to do this, to be honest. text, Caridon text. So these two, actually, will come in here. Actually, yeah, there is a better way to do this. Now, this still has to be a double, though. We don't even need this. Call it down here anyway. It won't do anything to it. And then, yeah, this becomes a one single column. It makes it better. Just went through that crazy stuff. Now we're going to have an item cost. And we'll see what that actually comes out to in terms of the value. 200, yeah, potion costs 240, wow. Yeah, I don't think so. But yeah, it's displaying correctly, though, because we have the, don't have a potion, don't have that many potions. But that's definitely not what we want to do. I also want to increase the this a little bit. Oh wow, now we got a bug here. What's it saying? Oh. Because we still need to have... Oh, wow. This is why. So, math floor... There. I've got to remove a few parentheses there. Well, exactly one, I guess. So, I removed one. Oh, we're getting kind of closer. We're at 80. Which, coincidentally, is the opposite here, which is kind of interesting. Okay. So... let's see what divided by 12 does, instead of whatever number I had there. 2.25 or whatever. The goal is to make the item cost be less, but still be significant. On higher levels. Well, now it's zero because we're dividing a lower by a higher amount, probably, or something. Of true 1 plus so if it's true then we'll just use this. If it's not true then we'll use this. That's how we'll get around that problem. So the potion cost is 160. Still too high. We're just doubling up on that, though, so... Well, it's divided by 2, divided by 12. That's actually an additional level of division. And we could just keep on adding on additional levels of division, but it just kind of gets ridiculous after a while. Still 160.